Hello everyone, today we are going to look at your bibliography and we are going to talk about three different things within this lesson. One, we're going to talk about how do I annotate a source, how do I tag a source, and also how do I print it? What's the best way to print this so that it's in a nice clean bibliography order? So those are the three things we're going to look at. So the first thing, when I want to tag a source, the reason you want to do this is if you're doing your National History Day project, the requirements are you need to sort your bibliography primary in one group and secondary in another group. And an easiest way to do this is by tagging. So if you go into your project, so for instance, if I'm in here and I opened up my bibliography, it's right here, horses, and I go down to my six citations or sources, what you'll want to do over here under More, click on More, and then you are going to go into and tap on Tags. And a tag means just like a hashtag or any of those things, a tag helps you to identify it or sort it by a category. So let's say this one is a primary source. And be careful, what you have to do is you do have to make sure that you're consistent. If you do capital P in one, do capital P in all of them. Or lowercase, whatever it might be, because it will sort it separately if you do them differently. So I'm going to update this. I'm going to call this a primary source. Refresh the page, and what you'll see is down in the bottom left of the box, up comes primary. So right now we have six citations. One is primary, and all the rest are uncategorized. Let's just do another one primary so you can kind of see what this looks like again. Again, capital P, because I used that once. And then do it consistently every time. So let's say these first two are primary sources. And if I scroll down a little bit here, if I refresh my page, it'll come in. It's tagging that one as a primary source. And then I want to add another source in here. Did it not save or update? We'll have to look at that again. If I go to this one again, let's just make sure that this is working. Go to tag. And you know, you have to problem solve. If that happens, it could happen. Don't go get frustrated. Just do it again. And then scroll down and it should refresh the page. It might be coming in a little bit slow because I am doing this at home. But it'll tag it. And then let's just do another one and call it secondary. And what you'll be able to see here in a minute is I can sort them. So if I do secondary, if I could type. And again, if you're using a capital S or whatever it might be. So I'm going to refresh this. And then if you have them all tagged, what I can do up here, see how this one came in under secondary and this one's under primary. If I'm going to sort them right up here where it says select, if I drop down arrow and, go over here to sort order. If I go down here, sort by tag, what it will do is it will put them all the primary together and the secondary together, and then you can quickly see which ones you have not tagged. So these didn't get tagged at all. So you'd have to go back in and see which ones you have to go in and tag. Then when you're ready to print it, what you'll want to do up here is export to copy and paste. And when you copy and paste, it'll bring them all out for you that you can copy and paste them and put them into your bibliography or whatever. And you might have to add some spaces for your primary and secondary. You have to really kind of look though back at your source. All right, which ones were primary? These two, this one was primary. So if I go back into my export, notice how this one's at the top. So what you would do, you're gonna copy all of this and then paste it into your Pages document or into your Google Drive docs, whatever's easiest for you to be working on. So you'll see they'll start to separate. The other thing that you'll need to do here is a big one also that National History Day requires this is called an annotated bibliography. Not just a bibliography here, a list, but an annotated one. And so what you do on that is if you click under Edit, it's going to bring up your source. You'll have to do this with every single one of your sources. And you're going to go down to the bottom here where it says Add Annotation. What an annotation is, it's a way to explain to the judges who are looking at your work, how did you find this source helpful? What did you have to do that you utilized it? All right. So let's say this horse, as you were looking at it, why did this group of people move west, and what you were using it for, whatever. You might put something in here. I utilized, instead of just saying the word used, I utilized, if I can type here, utilized this source. I utilized the source for helping me to understand the basic customs of this tribe. In addition, I used several pictures for the introduction. Man, I can't type tonight. I used several pictures for the introduction of my documentary. And so those are the things that you can put in there to explain how did you use it. Some might reinforce your information that you've already learned. Others that you're looking at it, you added it to the historical context part about the conflict. Or I use this part to put on my exhibit to clarify the compromise that happened in this incident or whatever it might be. So as you're doing your annotation, use that to explain what's going on. What you do then is you click Update Citation. And if you'll notice, now it has this annotation on it here. If you go down, you can see the blue one that's highlighted. It's now been annotated. So again, if I'm going to put it out, you'll see the difference here. So if I export it, this is just a review here to get it ready to print. Export, copy and paste. This one just seems to work consistently better than exporting to Google Docs or whatever. At least that's what we found. So if you look up here, this one is your primary source, and right here is your annotation. And notice how it's called a hanging indent over here on the left-hand side. It has the author's last name and then indents the second line and the third line and fourth line if your annotation gets fairly long. A correct bibliography or works cited page, hanging indent on the left, and then the rest of it comes in a little bit here. And it is alphabetized. So if you'll notice, it's alphabetized here by the author's last name. So that's how your teachers or the judges of National History Day, they also will be looking at it to make sure that you have done your bibliography correctly by sorting it by primary, secondary, and have it annotated, and also that it is alphabetically correct by each category. As you get going on this, if you have any questions, as always, don't be afraid to ask or watch this video again and help each other out. Need anything else? Let me know. Have a great day.